What's going on? It's Kyle Vinnick. If you watched my previous video, you know I've been spending a little time with this Pixel XL. It's been about 24 hours since I got the phone, and I just wanted to do a check-in as there is one issue I'd like to cover, and of course some great things I like about the phone. So I'm just gonna tap in three things and make it brief. Number one, the display. I just got back from using the iPhone 6S Plus, and on the Pixel XL, colors pop a lot more. It's not as saturated as the display on the Galaxy S7, but I actually like it that way. Also, it is definitely a step up from the last year's Nexus 6P, which had horrible viewing angles. On the 6P, I would lay my phone down and look at it from a very short distance, and that pink tint just felt very cheap to me. But on the Pixel XL, it's a lot better. You'll still see a little shift in the colors from certain angles, but that is expected from AMOLED displays. Number two, speakers. Now, I know we're all a little upset that at a high price range, we at least expect two speakers from this phone, especially when its somewhat predecessors carried them since the 2014 Nexus 6. But on here, we got only one single speaker at the bottom, which is actually really good. I know it could be a lot better if it was front-facing stereo speakers, like how most people want it, but I can say that the speaker on here is the best single speaker I've heard on a smartphone. Number three, charging. Now, the issue I had with this phone is fixed, or at least I hope so. So after my battery died at 4 a.m., that's when I finally plugged in the charger. Later, I woke up around 8 a.m., and I noticed my phone was still at very low battery. I checked if it was plugged in the outlet, and it was. So I unplugged the charger and plugged it back in, and tried to turn the phone on. It booted up, and it was at like 2% of battery life, but I noticed it kept charging and uncharging without me even touching the charging cable. So I unplugged and plugged once more, and with that insert, it felt more snappy and secure in the charger port. Now I doubt that there was something lodged in the charger port. The phone could have been too new and needed a little push to get the charging in place. I don't know. Or it could just be my charging cable. I just hope it's not a sign of future charging problems. But if you guys had the same issue, let me know. And just one more little thing, the buttons. I know you guys heard my first thoughts on the buttons on this phone, but I'd also like to add that the volume rocker doesn't click all at once like it did on the 6P. If I try to press in the middle of the button rocker, I'm only able to press one of the buttons when I press a little harder. That's how it's supposed to be, but I like to mention it anyway. So yeah, I just wanted to fill you guys in, mainly on my short-lived charging issue. I didn't want to say too much because I will be doing more coverage on this phone. It's only been about a day of usage, and as you can tell, I haven't even sorted my home screen or changed my wallpaper yet. That's pretty much it for this video. As always, comment down below. Let me know what you think about the video. Make sure you subscribe for the latest. Later.